Hello, everybody. Welcome. This is my continuation of financial accounting series, or excuse me, for managerial accounting series. This is my introduction. We're going to talk about product versus period costs, and then fixed, variable, and mixed costs. Okay, my disclaimer and copyright notice: the information and opinions in this presentation are those of myself and not my employers or affiliated organizations, including but not limited to Irvine Valley College and the South Orange County Community College District. Presentation is for educational purposes only and does not constitute any legal or accounting advice whatsoever. This presentation is copyright 2008 to 2023 by myself, Bennett Tchaikovsky. All rights are reserved. Any distribution is strictly prohibited. So again, product versus period cost. So when we're going through and as we're learning about managerial accounting, one of the things we've kind of looked at in the earlier example is this coloring book of just, you know, amazing things. When we talk about a product cost, it is something that is going to either go into raw materials, factory payroll, factory overhead, travels to work in process, goes to finished goods inventory, and it ends up over here at cost of goods sold. A product cost is going to be an inventoryable cost until it is sold. So when you hear the term product cost, it has to go through and relate to the product. Very, very important concept. So what types of things do you go through and see when you're looking at a product cost? Well, anything with the word factory in it, right? And you can kind of see it down here. Insurance expense on the factory, depreciation expense on the factory, cleaning services on the factory, utilities cost on the factory, production supplies, property tax expense. It has to really go out and say that this has factory in the description. Depreciation on machinery, direct materials, direct labor, right? It's directly related to production. Indirect materials, indirect labor. You're going to learn more about that in chapters, probably the next chapter, which is job order costing. Freight in, if I have to pay to have raw material shipped to me, that would go into my raw materials inventory. So when you hear the term product cost, it relates to the production or the product that we are going through and making. It is extremely important that you understand what that definition is, because if it's not a product cost, it is going to basically be a period cost. A period cost is not a product cost. It is immediately expense. What's the difference? Well, a product cost is going to sit in inventory until we actually go through and sell it through cost of goods sold. Whereas a period cost is expensed immediately. What are some examples of period cost? Sales commissions. Okay, if I have to pay someone to sell an item, I give them a commission. That is a sales commission. It is not part of product cost. It's a selling cost. Sales salary, selling cost. Office expenses, general and administrative. Executive salaries, general and administrative. Office equipment depreciation. Well, it's depreciation, but it's not factory. It's office equipment. Office supplies expense, marketing and advertising expense, corporate insurance, right? And this is a really, really important distinction. And the real reason why that this is so important is that when an investor is looking at a financial statement, right? When an investor says, this is more of a retailer than a manufacturer, so it's probably not the best one to go through and use, but it's an easy one to use. But if I'm going over here, I have sales, cost of sales, gross profit. There's something very important is this: when I see an expense, is it part of the selling part or is it part of general and administrative? Another one we can look at over here. Let's go ahead to Rivian Automotive. Always exciting to look at Rivian, right? We love the cars. They're driving around. Who knows for how much longer? I'm just kidding. If we come over here and we look at revenues, cost of revenues, right? So cost of revenues over here, they have $661 million of revenue. They had $1.2 billion of cost of goods sold. So when you look at this over here, when you see what was their product cost, it's right over here, the cost of revenue, another way of saying cost of goods sold. Then you have period costs. What are period costs? Period costs don't relate to the actual, directly relate to the selling of inventory. Rather, they relate to our business operations. And so as we can see here, they had R&D of almost 500 million. And then they had selling, general, and administrative costs of about 402 million. So it's very important for us that when we go through and we are classifying things out, that we make the distinction between what is a product cost and what is a period cost. So let's kind of go through and take a look at an example. And so here we have Zizix, which is that nice exit off of the I-15, manufactures electric bicycles. They had the following costs during the year related to the manufacture of 5,000 electric bicycles. So if we look over here, I'm making a bicycle. If I look at each of these different things, first one see here is I see a battery, right? Is that a product or a period cost? Well, if I'm making electric bicycles, the cost of the battery is definitely going to be a product cost. Over here, the next one I see is a metal frame. Well, if I need a metal frame for the e-bike, that's also going to be a product cost because if I'm selling electric bicycles, it's part of the cost of the bike. Direct labor. Well, that's directly assembling the different components into an electric bike. So that's also going to be a product cost. Remember, anything that's coming over here is going to be a product cost. So if I would see it over here, it means it's got to be a product cost. Bike components, that's again a product cost because I'm making bicycles. Machinery depreciation, well, I'm going to assume that this is basically from the factory, and I can even write this up here, make this a little bit clearer, right? But this is also going to be a product cost. Rent on factory building. Oh, it has the word factory in it, so therefore it must be a product cost. Rent on office building. Well, if it's the office and not the factory, it's going to be a period cost, meaning it's part of selling, general, and administrative. Office manager salary. Well, it's not a part of the factory, so it must be a period cost. Factory supervisor salary. Wow, this must be a product cost. Office equipment rent. Oh, it's the office, not Michael Scott, but it's the office, must be period. Okay, now, sales commissions. This always messes up students. It is a period cost because it does not relate to the production. It's the selling of what we've produced. So this over here would be a period cost. Advertising. This is also going to be a period cost. Selling, general, administrative. Advertising the product, sales commissions. Executive salaries, right? Those are all period costs, meaning that they're going to go into selling, general, and administrative expenses, SG&A. You'll see different companies break out their financial statements differently. The reason why the Home Depot likes to break out depreciation and amortization is because this is a non-cash charge, but we can talk about that later. So as we come back over here, and this is how we have product or period. Product has to go through and relate to the production. It's ultimately going to go get transferred from finished goods. Once it's sold, it goes to cost of goods sold. Anything else is pretty much going to be selling, general, and administrative costs. So that's the first kind of distinction that we need to understand going into this. Now let's talk about the next type of distinction. What's fixed, variable, or mixed? Okay, so I'm only going to focus today on fixed and variable. I will focus on mixed later on in the semester. But when we look at fixed production costs, what is a fixed cost? This means it's a cost that will not change with production. If I make 10 units or 100 units, the cost stays the same. Best examples of this, factory equipment depreciation, straight line. Factory insurance, factory property taxes, those generally will not change with different levels of production. However, direct as opposed to fixed, we have variable. With variable production over here, direct materials, those are absolutely variable. Why are they variable? Because they vary with production. If I make 10 bikes versus 100 bikes or 1,000 bikes, well, I need more tires. Well, I need more bike chains. Well, I need more batteries. Sure, need all that stuff, right? Direct labor. Is it going to take me longer to make 100 units than 10? Yeah, I'm going to need more labor to help me assemble those things. So I'll need more labor to build these things. So variable, it varies with production. If I make 10,000 units versus 10, I'm going to need more labor to make those 10,000 units. If it's 10 units versus 10,000, I'm going to need more materials. So again, that's variable versus fixed. Fixed stays the same, variable will change. Now a mixed cost has something of both. There's a fixed component and a variable component. And for that, there's different ways of going through and determining how a cost is mixed, meaning that there's probably going to be a fixed baseline and then part of it's going to be variable. We're not going to go through and I'm not going to test you on that until I believe it might be chapter 23, when we go through and do business decisions, we'd accept additional business. So, but for right now, think about fixed and variable. Now, what about, so that was production costs, right? They vary with production, but now let's look at over here is let's talk about period costs, right? So period costs, what's a period cost? We just said it was part of SG&A, right? So over here, fixed SG&A, these are not going to change with production. Corporate insurance, office equipment depreciation, office staff salaries. Variable SG&A, sales commissions. Now, with this part over here too, is you might say, well, Bennett, what if we pay our salesperson a base salary and then we pay them commission on top? That would be a mixed cost. But for right now, when we're seeing sales commissions, what I want you to be thinking about is the variable component. If I sell 10 items, I'm going to owe a certain amount of commissions, but if he sells 100 or she sells 100, then I'm going to owe more. So again, just kind of go through and think about it from that standpoint. So let's go over here now and complete the rest of our question. So over here, the battery. So again, ask yourself the question, if I make 5,000 electric bikes or 10,000 electric bikes, well, I need more batteries. The answer is yes. So this is going to be a variable cost. Over here for the metal frame, if I make 5,000 or 10,000, well, I need more metal frames. The answer is absolutely yes. So it's going to be variable. Same thing with direct labor, bike components. Okay. So these are all variable because if I make 5,000 versus 100,000 bikes, I'm going to need more bike components, labor to basically go through and make those items. Factory machinery depreciation straight line. This is a fixed cost. Okay. So this will be fixed. Rent on factory building. Factory, right? We already know it's a product cost, but this is going to be fixed. Unless you're given additional information, it'll be a fixed cost. Okay, rent on office building, right? This is also going to be a fixed cost. We're generally not going to pay anything beyond the base amount of the rent. There are different ways, though, that rent is structured, but that's for you to find out later in one of the honors or in another class you take with me. Okay, office manager salary, again, that's going to be fixed. We're not giving them a bonus or anything else. So there you go. Factory supervisor salary. Also going to be a fixed cost. Office equipment rent, fixed cost, right? It's not going to be variable unless I gave you more information. Sales commission, right? This is a period cost, but it is variable because this is going to change in terms of how we go through and work it. Advertising, this is also going to be a fixed cost. Now, if we were doing something where we went to Facebook or Google and they basically, or Meta and Google, and they said, okay, well, depending on how much you want to spend, this is what we can give you, then it could be variable. But for our purposes right now, this is what we're going to go through and do. So what I'm going to do now is I'm going to go ahead and end this video. We've just kind of gone through and discussed this first part over here. is basically identifying all costs as variable fixed, and then identify a cost as product or period. And then over here, we're asked to basically determine the per unit amount for the product costs that are variable. Let's go ahead and do that now. So variable product cost right over here. And that's it. Okay, so the per unit, basically per unit of this is, how do I figure that out? Well, I'm going to take my total cost of 400,000 and I'm going to divide it by the units produced. So this relates to the manufacture of 5,000 units. So my per unit is going to be over here, not false, but it will be $80 per unit. Okay, my metal frame, I take 1.5 million divided by the number of units being produced. My per unit is going to be 300. Direct labor over here, 4.5 million, 5,000 units. This is going to be at 900. My bike components that are at 625,000. I've got 5,000 units here, and this is going to be at 125. Okay, now, why is this part important? Because when I come back to the next video, what we're going to be going through and doing is we're going to say, well, this is at 5,000. What happens if we sell 5,200? What does it look like if we sell these other parts here? So that's what we're going to go through and do, but on the next video. And I look forward to seeing you then. And I want to thank you for liking and subscribing. Helps out the channel a lot. And please feel free to leave any questions that you might have or comments. And I look forward to seeing you on the next video. Have a great day, and I will see you soon. Have a good one.